The revolution will be live.
Two people who work in this White House, of course, the press secretary Sarah Sanders and the counselor to the president, Kellyanne Conway, both joining us now, of course. Welcome to the both of you. You look great.
Thank you.
So the president is not here tonight, as he was not last year either. He is instead at a rally with his supporters. But last year, what's different is that no one who worked in the White House attended the dinner last year. But of course, we have a plethora of aides with us now. Why are you attending this year if you didn't attend last year? Both of you worked in the administration last year. What's different this year?
I mean, the biggest difference, the president encouraged his staff and all of us to attend, and so we did, and we felt like it was important for us to come out and be here.
Well, as usual, we're doubling the coverage. We're here on behalf of the president and in celebration of the First Amendment, and the president is in Michigan touting the very strong economy and the prosperity and security that his administration has brought to bear.
So you say he encouraged you to come this year. Why did he think that his staffers should come, but he chose instead to go to Michigan for a rally?
I think Kellyanne made the point best. We have double the coverage. She's out promoting the extremely successful first year and a half that he's had as president, and we get to do that here. And it's going to be, I think, a great night both here and in Michigan.
He also encourages us to have fun. He's a really great boss, and he believes in having a fun and social workplace. He talks about that often. And I guess I would ask the question, Caitlin, why wouldn't we come?
What did you do last year during the dinner? Were you at
the
rally?
I went to Harrisburg with the president to the Harrisburg area. We went to AIM. It's one of the nation's largest wheelbarrow producers, a really incredible success story. And it is there that the president signed two executive orders. One was establishing his trade office at the White House, and another one with some trade measures. And that's so prophetic given the great strides he's made on fair but reciprocal trade and continues to. I'm also here to celebrate the successes that we see in Korea. I mean, this president has really set the climate that allows North Korea and South Korea to literally come together and try to declare an end to decades long war. And it's really terrific that the president can do that and go to Michigan and we can come and have fun. I'm so proud of Sarah Sanders, I have to say. She knows I love her to begin with and respect her enormously, but she's representing the President of the United States tonight at the head table.
Thank you, Kellyanne.
Certainly, you'll be at the head table with supporters. Back to North Korea, you just mentioned that. The president, of course, is on the phone today with the leaders of South Korea and Japan. When this meeting was first announced, there was a lot of skepticism over whether or not it would actually happen. And, of course, cautious optimism we see coming from the president and his Twitter account in recent days. How likely is it that the president does actually sit down face-to-face with the North Korean dictator here in a few weeks?
Look, I think it's very likely. We've seen tremendous progress that's taken place over the last month due to the leadership under this president. He's been able to work with other leaders across the world, whether it was President Xi in China, President Moon of South Korea, and really bring people together to put maximum pressure on North Korea that's brought them to the table. And I think all of his leadership and efforts you've seen kind of culminate over the last week. And we certainly hope that this meeting takes place, because it would be certainly a great thing for the United States, but an even better thing for the world. And we're happy about the progress, but not naive about this process either. And the president's going to be take things one day at a time, but we're moving forward.
The president said the location choices for that sit-down has been narrowed down to two locations. Can you give us a hint of what those two could be?
Absolutely not. I think that's a great way to wrap up and head on inside and have a good time.
One more question.
Option A and option B.
One more question. Reince Priebus, we just spoke with him, the former chief of staff, of course, in the West Wing, someone who both of you worked with. He said he thinks there's a chance that the president could attend the dinner next year. Do you think that that is true?
As the president likes to say, we'll see what happens. There's always a chance, and you never know, but we'll see what happens.
And he did a great job at Gridiron earlier this year, so he obviously appreciates this type of format. At the same time, I suspect and I predict confidently, Caitlin, that next year he'll have more great economic and security news to tout. So he'll probably be back out there with among the folks who want the president to visit their community, and maybe he'll send some of us, but like he says, you'll never know. It keeps you guessing.
Well, thank you both for joining us. Enjoy the dinner.
Thanks. Have a good night.
All right, Anna, we just spoke with Kellyanne and Sarah Sanders, the press secretary. We'll toss it back to you and come back if we have any other White House staffers who join us here on the red carpet at the White House Correspondents' Dinner in Washington.
And we saw Stormy Daniels' lawyer, Michael Avenatti, photobombing a little bit there at the end of that interview. You never know who you're going to run into on the red carpet at the White House Correspondents' Dinner. Caitlin Collins, thank you. Our panel.
The revolution will be live.